Okay guys, we are here with another product review, and this time it is the Turkeyless Ground from Trader Joe's. That's right, Jules. And this is made with pea and wheat protein. Of course, it's vegan, plant-based. It's perishable, keep refrigerated, 21 grams of protein per serving. And I was like, what can we make with turkey? I mean, I haven't cooked turkey in so long, so definitely not ground turkey. And then my daughter was like, oh, we can maybe try making some turkey enchiladas. So we found a couple recipes for that, and we're going to do that. But we're first going to season this up. Well, let's look at the nutrition facts for every, it says there's 3 servings per container. Okay, the serving size is 4 ounces. And it's 230 calories. It's made from water, pea protein, textured wheat protein, which is wheat gluten and wheat starch, seasoning and flavor blend, potassium chloride, sunflower lecithin, yeast extract, salt, natural flavors, maltodextrin, spices, coconut oil, sunflower oil, methyl cellulose, natural flavors, seasoning, again, salt, sugar, black pepper, paprika. It contains wheat. It is not gluten-free. And it's got 12 grams of fat, 5 per serving, 5 grams of saturated fat, no trans fat, no cholesterol, 440 milligrams of sodium, 0.1 microgram, I guess, of vitamin D, and 10 milligrams of calcium, 11 grams of carbs, 3 grams of fiber, less than 1 gram of sugar, 21 grams of protein, and 4.1 milligrams of iron, and 440 milligrams of potassium. So we're going to open this up, get it in the pan, start to just saute this and flavor this, and we're gonna make some enchiladas. And if you might remember, I bought enchilada sauce as well at Trader Joe's, so we're going to, for the first time, make that and see how this turns out. This is what it looks like. Definitely looks like a minced meat here. And I guess, what else would we make with turkey, Chloe? Like, I mean, this is making me think of like a chicken salad or something, but I feel like it should be cooked.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we're cooking this. I'm happy to use this to make like Mexican fire stuff. I'm good with that. We love our spicy things. I can sort of smell the wheat gluten smell to it.
It kind of smells similar-ish to Beyond my ground beef, but not quite as strong.
Okay. Well, we're going to season this up with, like, what are we going to put in here? Ancho chili, habanero, whatever, taco seasoning.
Yeah.
Stuff like that. And is this enough, maybe, for one?
I think when we have the beans.
Yeah, because we've got beans we're going to put in here. So, yeah, maybe that'll be enough for, like, 4.
Yeah.
Is that good?
Yeah.
Okay, well, we'll see. If it's not, we can always make more. Okay, so this is about half the package, and it's definitely a good amount. We're going to put some black beans in here, get the enchiladas going. So I tasted it. It's really tasty, and we've made this, you know, with some habanero pepper, some ancho chili, some smoked paprika, some taco seasoning, so it's got a nice kick to it. And my daughter said she thinks it tastes like turkey without that raw taste, if you know what we're talking about. So it is really good. Give me an idea. What else should I make with ground turkey, vegan ground turkey? But yeah, we're going to, I guess, work on getting the enchiladas formulated, and we're going to use the sauce that I got at Trader Joe's, and we're going to get it into the oven or toaster oven and bake, and we're going to see how this turns out. Okay, so this is the Trader Joe's enchilada. We've seen a couple recipes on how to do this, so some say to put the sauce on each tortilla. One of them said to put it at the bottom of the pan, but I think we prefer this idea instead. So we're going to put some around like this, right, Chloe?
Yes.
I'm going to put a little in my hand and taste it. Okay, definitely has. I mean, I'm glad I bought this and now you thought about, I don't know if you thought about this because I bought this, but it's kind of perfect. So basically we're supposed to put a little bit of, how much were we supposed to put on here? Just some sort of down the middle, right?
Yeah.
So we can, and like they had cheese that they put on theirs as well. Oh, I think that's maybe enough. I was thinking about the green chilies.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm going to cut that, or I'm going to at least, we'll see. We're going to decide on that. But what you're going to do is, you're either going to add cheese to this if you want. We figure we'll probably just put cheese on top.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to roll this, you're going to roll it over. And then you're going to put it in your pan. You're going to put more enchilada sauce over top. You're going to put the vegan cheese on there. So we'll assemble and be back. Okay, this is what they look like. And I'm gonna pour some of this enchilada sauce on top, just like that. Okay, hopefully that's good. And I'm gonna use a mix of Violife and something else. I'm gonna use a mix of the Riviera mozzarella and the Violife cheddar. Not sure if I posted the review of this yet, but I'm gonna get that on there and I'm gonna bake at 350 for like 20 minutes. Okay, so there's the cheese on there and I'm gonna put it into the oven and get this cooked. Okay, this is what it looks like and we will taste and tell you how it is. Look at how good this looks. Okay, so that's our freshly made pico, guac, and our first time making enchiladas. I seem to have lost or misplaced my SD card with the final videos, so I'll just say that this was a really delicious meal. You can absolutely use this turkeyless ground for enchiladas, and I love it. Thank you, Trader Joe's. You've got lots of great options. That's all for now, guys. See you in the next video.